Well, hey up everybody, it's that time of month again. No, not that time, allotment update time. So it's a bit unprompted. I haven't brought my camera down. I'm on my phone, so I've been busy with work and family commitments, so I haven't really done any updates, but I thought I'd do a brief one to show you where I'm up to and how things are going. So in front of you, these are my shallots, red and white, which seem to be holding out at the minute, not come to the succumb to the onion fly or eel worm. We're still not sure what it is. Beetroot, been taking that already. French beans, dwarf ones. These were some more shallots. I stood on them because not stood on them, but been working around them because I took a row of calabrese out, and I've almost finished taking these now. So, but I'll use these as shallots, as spring onions. They'll be fine. Spring onions, still got a few left. Parsnips, these are the ones that I chitted. Really happy with them. A few more shallots, carrots. These were the pelleted ones. These were the ones that I did first. These are sweet candle, and then these small ones are the autumn king that don't seem to be germinating very well. But hey ho. Strawberries. Yes, we've had quite a few, but not as not really prolific. But it is the first year, and I were going to strip them and take all fruit off and all runners, but under pressure from the family, ended up leaving them. Although I am taking the runners off, I've still got to come and get some this week. Some runners, I mean, take the runners off. Just had a few late ones at work past week or so. I'm going to greenhouse. This is me overwintering garlic. As you can see, it's very rusty. And a few onions that had managed to survive. Alright, so down here. These are the Japanese peppers supplied by Gary Entropy. They're doing really well. I'm really pleased with them. They're really early fruiting. I do grow a sweet pepper, but it's a late fruiting one, Jimmy Nardell, so that'll be brilliant. That they're early, I mean, Jimmy's will be later. Got my chilies, my jalapenos, and some more. I think these are sweet peppers. So they're doing really well. Okay, a good height on them now. That was my spare cucumber, it doesn't seem to be growing. And I've got some cucamelons at the side, which I'm starting to put little fruit on. I don't like cucumbers anyway. Tomatoes, I'm a mixed bag with tomatoes this year. Some are doing really well and some aren't, so I think it was my fault. I think I stressed them out when they were small plants, so they're not brilliant. And look at that one. And I've given them a feed. I've given them magnesium, Epsom salts. So anyway, I've got some more at home. I'll show you them in a minute when I go up there. But and tomatoes on them at a minute, so they're starting to come. It's not the best crop I've ever had. So we'll take you, show you the first lot of potatoes. So these are doing really well. There's three rows here. Well, it looks like one big bed, but step back. Sorry about that. We've got park next door to us, and kids like to hang out and make a noise. Well, you expect that in a field, don't you? At least they're not hurting anybody. And then these are my shallots. These don't seem to be moving as far as they were last year, but this is the bed that's had the onion fly or eel worm. We're still not sure. I mean, some people are saying that they've seen bugs in theirs, like little grubs, so that's onion fly. And then other people haven't seen any, like myself. And that's why we're thinking it's eel worm. So I think it could be a mixture of both. It was such a mild winter though, weren't it? So my onions started to flop over. Garlic at the back, rusty. So it's about ready to come out of this. It will do when I get round to it, when I have 5 minutes to myself. Sweet corn. Stand back so we can see what we're looking at. Yeah, it's not doing too bad. I put some squashes in the middle, like the old Three Sisters, but I ain't got beans. Yeah, that one's not doing very well. But I have got two more in greenhouse that I'm gonna put in. Might put them in here, I don't know yet. We'll see. It's when I get 5 minutes to my son. Courgettes. These sort of things are taking the time this year. I'm sure this time last year I got massive courgettes, but hey ho. Potato field. So there. Them onwards are the ones that I put in into the ground. And these in front of me are the ones in the pots. And they're going bonkers. Foliage is like, oops, nearly fell there. It's past my navel and I'm 5'10", so probably about 3.5 foot. And they're buried quite deep into the soil. So, pink fir apple. Then I've got, trying to remember, pink fir apple, two pink fir apple, two carra, two blue kestrel. And then I've got four sarpomeras are the end ones here with the big leaves. So they look to be doing really well, but I'm a bit dubious when there's lots of foliage. I mean, as you can see these here, these are first dahlias at front, Winston's with the flowers on, then second dahlias, two row of second dahlias, and then the ones at the back I'll show you in a minute when I go over there are the main crop. My leeks, four row of leek, and then some more shallots. I've got loads of shallots this year. These are from seed as well, these are the red ones, so you see how they go. And then we've got brassica city here. So we've got these three cabbages that somebody gave me. They gave me enough for a row, but there are only three survived. And then these are calabri, more calabri. And then that's another under there, they're all calabri. Under this first net, these are all cauliflowers. Rally. And then under there I've got their cabbages, squadron, and then that John gave me that I've just called John's cabbages, they're an autumn one. They're doing really well. The back row are the squadron, the front row are the autumn ones. So they're looking really well. And the late, so the squadron ones, they sit in the ground really well, they hold, so doing alright. My French beans. Really ahead of last year. I had a rubbish crop of French beans last year, and I think this has helped putting a windbreak at the bottom. That's made a big difference, and they took, and we've had loads off already. To be honest, we've had three meals off it, and I've got enough in a carrier bag in the fridge for tomorrow, and we could blanch some if we need to. Me sunflowers, probably 5 foot tall. Got two more at the end here. I'm a bit conscious that I'm running a long time because I've got to upload this and it can take all night. So I'll be going a bit fast, I do apologise. These are my sprouts. Obviously they're going to get a lot taller, so I'll end up raising this net. And I have got me kale in behind. I've only recently put it in. And I like that when it's prospering on it. But so that's alright. And then this bit, put some netted membrane down. Only cheap stuff from Wilco's. and I put some squashes through it. We've got 3, 4, 8 squashes and 3 pumpkins. Now, they've been in a while, they don't seem to be moving. They're greening up though, so we'll see how they go. Cleared all this area, I know it doesn't look like it, but we had a skip, so all the rubbish, apart from that there, just got to tidy that up. Could be getting my shed sorted soon, so seen the guy today and he said looking at starting it next week, so shouldn't be too long. And then that's the main crop, them two rows there. Don't seem to be a lot of foliage, but main crop is slow, aren't they? So we can tell where which gets the sun, because it's really good them three rows, and then starts to go sparse. They're second early, they're Pentland Javelin, I think they are, in this bit. So we can see where the sun is. Well, this side seems to get a lot more sun. I mean, that comfrey, I keep cut that back 3 times now. Right, so I'll show you me disastrous peas. So, here we are. I don't know if it's because I did a trench. Better get them in shot, sorry about that. I did a trench and filled it with manure. I don't usually do that. I usually manure my ground, rotivate it in autumn, dig it in, then rotivate it in spring, but I didn't get any manure, as you know, until February, so it had to be done like that. But won't be doing it again. And I think somewhere it might have been the seed as well. It's a bit weedy down here. It needs to be sorted, but get that sorted soon. You seen all the tadpoles? Now, I've had one batch without putting myself, and then a frog moved in, or two frogs, and laid a load more frog spawn. So there's going to be loads, and snails keep falling in off of the plants I've got above them, and they keep eating them, so they're getting a taste for it already. I've got these to put in if I ever get chance. I've watered these before I go. These are, if I can find the label, right, these are, no, can't read it. I can't think of the name of them. They're like a broccoli, but they're also like a calabrese. They're like a calabrese, but they're also like a cauliflower. Lime green. I'll probably write it on screen, you'll see what they are, but it just escapes me at the moment. Right, so that's loads of stuff in my compost bin. Right, so that's where I'm up to at the minute, at the allotment, and the allotment greenhouse. I'm going to finish watering up and I'll nip home and show you what's going on in the greenhouse at home. Right folks, I'm at home now in the greenhouse, so I'll just do a whistle stop tour in here. Cucumbers, yes, we're getting cucumbers. These are the lunch pail size, lunchbox size for my lad. I don't eat cucumbers, well, I've got 3 in them in, and I've got a little cucumelon down there that somebody's given me, as well as the 2 of the allotment. So quite a few started to come on these. We have had a couple off, so yeah, fine. These are the that one's not doing too well. These are dwarf variety from Lidl's. Thought I'd give them a go and see how they went. I think I should have made behind you. That one's not too bad. So I should have only put 1 in a pot, but that one seems to be okay. These actually got a bean on. Last year I grew these in the border on the allotment, and they did much better and much quicker, but what can you do? You've only got pots. So on to the tomatoes. And these are doing better, if not as far in advance as the ones in the greenhouse at the allotment. Boy, I'm happier with these. I did have to replace 2. Which ones were these? I replaced 2
cherries with a sweet million and a gardener's delight. Well, they're behind a bit. I had to go to garden centre and buy them, £1.50 each. I bought any tomatoes for about 4 or 5 years, so it would be a bit of a shock for the old system. But I think that's a pepper, that one. Not a pepper, a chilli. They're not doing as well here. I don't think they can get quite as much sun, but tomatoes aren't doing too bad. So that's the whistle stop tour. So a bit of lettuce down there. Just do bits and bobs. Some down here, some Mizuna. Actually, that needs watering. Some more down there, just starting off. So, I had to take a pane of glass out because it's getting too hot in here. I ain't got a window in here. I do leave the door open, but I'm going to bring the louver vents from the allotment and put them in there and put the glass from there into one allotment. So I've got a light in window, in roof, I mean. So, yes, steady progress. I am way behind that I usually am in greenhouse, but I did have another allotment to sort out as well, so I can't be too disappointed. And they're all fruit, so that'll be okay. I'm showing me rhubarb. As you know, the potatoes have gone, so I'll end on the rhubarb, and I'll see you later. Get the door open.